The React Native features and tools are constantly evolving, and it's important to know what's available to get the best performance out of them. In today's episode of A Guide to React Native Optimization, let's start with a rule that probably makes a lot of sense. Always run the latest React Native version to access the new features. I'll admit this one is quite obvious. Basically, always be on the watch out for new updates because it often means new features, performance improvements, and security fixes. Now, because it might be difficult to switch from one version to another, know that there are also tools for that, such as reactnative upgrade helper, that gives you an overview of what changed since the last time you've upgraded. You can also usually find a list of breaking changes for native and JavaScript packages that you're using. Massive updates like the one from 2019, where Google Play required every application to be 64-bit, can be critical for your business. Always make sure to be up to date for more features and better support. Debug faster and better with Flipper. Profiling and debugging with console logs and Chrome Debugger can be very limiting. It usually gives you a rough idea of what might cause the issues, but it's sometimes not enough for getting to the bottom of it. A great solution to that is Flipper, which not only helps you understand your JavaScript errors, but also the native ones. You don't have to run Xcode or Android Studio to debug the native issues, because Flipper does exactly this. Additionally, it ships with React DevTools, Hermes Debugger, and Metro Bundler integration. Having the right debugging tools is essential for moving faster, so give Flipper a try if you haven't yet. Automate your dependency management with auto-linking. For a long time, adding native libraries was difficult for beginners. This was because on iOS, React Native projects were now using dependency managers such as CocoaPods. It had to be done manually or through the React Native link command, which could sometimes lead to very confusing installation instructions. Hopefully, the community has slowly moved over to CocoaPods for handling iOS dependencies, and Gradle remained its Android counterpart. This allowed to completely automate the native library's installations using what they called auto-linking. In short, it does all the work for you when installing a native dependency. This helped immensely with reducing the gap between JavaScript and React Native packages setup workflows. Optimize your Android application starter time with Hermes. Today, there is fierce competition when it comes to mobile apps, and your starter time is crucial to keep users on board. The problem with React Native is that it needs to start a JavaScript virtual machine when booting the app so that your code can run inside that box. While it's using the built-in JavaScript core on iOS, React Native relies on the same technology on Android, which in that case is not as optimized as it could be for the platform. This is why a team at Facebook came up with Hermes, a React Native engine created just for Android at first. Its biggest strength is how it took both parsing and compilation steps away from the running process to instead execute them during build time. This allows your Android app to run bytecode directly, which in turn makes your app faster to start and also drastically reduces the file size. When making an Android app, remember to turn it on and see if all your libraries are compatible. If they are, Hermes should definitely make a difference for you. Optimize your Android application size with Gradle settings. By default, a React Native application on Android mostly consists of four sets of binaries compiled for different CPU architectures. This ultimately impacts your bundle size, since every user will install all of these files while they only need one of them. To solve this issue, you can use the App Bundle format, which Google Play smartly uses to build architecture-specific versions of your application. The average reduction size using this format is 35%, but can sometimes be even bigger than that. An additional way of reducing your app size is to use Proguard, which removes unused code from native dependencies and minifies the code base. Keeping your app size as small as possible is the best way for your app to be downloaded from anyone in the world, where most devices might not be as fast as yours. Alright, before we end, here's a quick recap of these 5 rules to optimize your application. 1. Always run the latest React Native version. 2. Debug faster and better with Flipper. 3. Automate your dependency management with auto-linking. 4. Optimize your Android application startup time with Hermes. And 5. optimize your Android application size with Gradle settings. Okay, that's it for today. If you are a curious person, you can expect a lot more videos on this channel. Remember to subscribe if you don't want to miss it. Thanks for watching and see you next time.